माय नेम इज रश्मि सिंह। मैं आपसे ये बोलना चाहती हूँ कि मैंने इस्लाम दिल से कबूल कर लिया, पर मैं चाहती हूँ कि आप मुझे कलमा पढ़ाएं।
Sister said that she wants to accept Islam and she wants me to make her read the Shahada. Do you understand English, sister?
Yes.
Do you believe there's one God?
Yes.
Do you believe that idol worship is wrong?
Yes.
Do you believe that Prophet Muhammad is the final messenger of God?
Yes.
Is anyone forcing you to accept Islam?
No.
Is there any economic pressure?
No.
Is there any physical pressure?
No.
Are you accepting with your free will?
Yes.
Yes, sister. So I will inshallah recite the kalma in Arabic and you can repeat it. Ashadu.
Ashadu.
Allah.
Allah.
Ilaha.
Ilaha.
Illallah.
Illallah.
Wa ashadu.
Wa ashadu.
Anna.
Anna.
Muhammadan.
Muhammadan.
Abduhu.
Abduhu.
Wa rasuluhu.
Wa rasuluhu.
I bear witness. That. There is no God.
But Allah.
And Prophet Muhammad.
Peace be upon him.
Is his servant and messenger. MashaAllah, sister. Now you are a Muslim. And I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that may He guide you. And may He keep you on the straight path. As Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Al-Imran chapter 3, verse number 8. رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدِ إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا وَهَبْ لَنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمَةً إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَهَّابُ. That, O Lord, please keep us on the straight path after Thou has guided us and keep us on the straight path. So I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that may He give you more hidayah to keep you in the straight path and may He grant you Jannah.
So I want to ask you one question. Sir, agar mere ghar pe mere parents ko is baare mein pata chalta hai, to how can I, main unko samjhau kaise ki main jo kar raha hu sahi hai?
Sister has a question that if the parents come to know at home, how will she convince the parents that what she's doing is the truth? Sister, first thing is that you start loving your parents more, number one. Start loving your mother and father more, obey them, respect them, follow them, unless if they tell you something against Allah and His Rasul, that's the only time you disobey. There should be a difference between what you were before and what you are now. Maybe you never used to follow many of their advice. Now, as long as what they say doesn't go against Quran and Sahih Hadith, my request to you is, even if you don't like it, you start following. They should see a difference. This is my daughter before she was a Muslim, and now this is my daughter after she accepted Islam. If they find a change in you, they will start asking you, "Are, yesterday you weren't following me, now you're following everything what I'm saying." Immediately. Why? This is what the Quran says. This is what our beloved Prophet said, that paradise lies beneath the feet of your mother. In this way, you try and win them over. The Quran says in Surah Futilah chapter number 41, verse number 34, that it is better to win over them, and it can be done with hikmah. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Nahl, chapter number 16, verse number 125, Udu ila sabili rabbika bil hikmah wal mu'azatil hasna wajadun billati asan. Invite all to the way of thy Lord with wisdom and beautiful preaching, and argue with them and reason with them in ways that are best and most gracious. I would request you to give my DVD, Similarities Between Islam and Hinduism, to your parents, and inshallah it will soften their heart. And I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that may give hidayah to your parents also and to your family members.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, brother. Mic number one in the front.
Dr. Jakir Naik, sir, main tahe dil se aapko namaste kehta hoon. Mera naam Eshu Das hai. To mera prashn is tarah se hai ki Islam kitni shaadi karne ka ijazat deta hai aur kyun?
Brother asked the question that how many marriages are permitted in Islam and why, referring to the polygamy.
Matlab main janna chahta hu ki Quran ke anusar mein sahi mein kitna hona chahiye aur kitna nahi hona chahiye.
According to the Quran, how many marriages can you do? As far as the woman is concerned, according to Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 20 to 24, a married woman cannot marry again, so women should have only one husband maximum. As far as the other is concerned, Quran says in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 3, marry women for choice in twos, threes or fours, but if you can't do justice, marry only one. You can marry two, three or four, but if you can't do justice, marry only one. This statement, marry only one if you can't do justice, is only given in the Quran. There's no other scripture on the face of the earth which says marry only one besides the Quran. If you read the Ramayana, if you read the Mahabharata, you can marry as many wives as you want. If you read Ramayana, the father of Ram, how many wives he had? He had more than one wife. Krishna, if you read Mahabharata, how many wives he had? 16,108 wives. So when Krishna can have 16,108 wives, so why can't we Muslims have up to four? If you read the Bible, in the Old Testament as the New Testament, you can marry as many wives as you wish. Solomon had 700 wives. Abraham had 3 wives according to the Bible. It is the church which put up a limit. Christians should marry only one. It is Rabbi Ben Shimgan Hauda who passed a synod that Jews should marry only one. In India, it is the Indian Penal Code in 1954 which passed a law in Hindu Marriage Act which said that Hindu should marry only one. It is the Indian Penal Code, not the Hindu scripture, which says that Hindu should have only one wife. Let's analyze what are the reasons that Islam gives permission for a man to have more than one wife. Marrying more than one wife is not compulsory in Islam, it's optional. But if you marry more than one wife, you should do justice between your wives. The logical reasons we can think that Islam has given permission are that male and female are born in equal proportion. But if you ask any medical doctor, any pediatrician, he will tell you that the girl, the female child, is a stronger sex medically as compared to the male child. She can fight the germs and diseases much better than a male child. So more female children are alive as compared to male children. As life goes on, there is death due to war, due to accident, due to cigarette smoking, due to alcohol. In all these cases, more male are dying as compared to female. So today in the world, there are more females in the world as compared to males. In few third world countries like India, etc., where the female population is less than the male population because of female infanticide and female feticide. Every year in India, more than 1 million fetuses are being aborted after they identified that they are females. If this evil practice stops, even in India, the male population will become less than the female population. In New York alone, there is 1 million female more than males. In USA alone, there are 7.8 million female more than males. In UK alone, there are 4 million female more than males. In Germany alone, there are 5 million female more than males. In Russia alone, there are 9 million female more than males. And God alone knows how many millions of females are more than males throughout the world. If I agree with you that one man should only marry one woman, and suppose the market is saturated, and if your sister happens to live in America, or my sister happens to live in America, and if she happens to be one of the 7.8 million females who has not found a life partner, the only option for her is that she either marries a man who already has a wife, or she becomes public property. Public property, such a harsh word. This is the most sophisticated word I can use. I cannot think of a better word than this. And any modest woman would say that if the option is given, she would prefer marrying a man who already has a wife or become public property. Hope that answers the question.
We will not allow any further questions, but the volunteers are pointing out someone. This was the last question actually, but we'll allow that Shahada, and inshallah we'll carry on with the other program.
Do you believe there's one God? Brother.
Hello.
In the first place, do you believe there's one God? Kya mante khuda ek hai?
Hello, assalamu alaikum.
Do you believe there's one God? Kya mante ki khuda ek hai?
Ek hi God karke yakeen rakhta hu.
Aap mante ki Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam aakhri paigambar hai?
Ha, manta hu.
Aap mante?
Manta.
Aap pe koi zabardasti kar raha hai Islam qabul karne ke liye? Koi aap pe zabardasti kar raha hai?
Nahi.
आप अपने मर्जी से कबूल करना चाहते
हैं
बोथ द ब्रदर्स इंशाल्लाह दे कैन से द शहादा अल जस्ट से इन अरबिक एंड यू कैन रिपीट इट एंड देन वी कैन हैव द नेक्स्ट सेशन अशहदु
अशहदु
अल्लाह
अल्लाह
इलाहा
इलाहा
इल्लल्लाह
इल्लल्लाह
वाशहदु
अन्ना
अन्ना
मुहम्मदन
मुहम्मदन अब्दुहु
अब्दुहु
व रसूलुहु
व रसूलुहु
मैं
गवाही देता हूं
के अल्लाह
अल्लाह
के अलावा
इलावा
कोई माबूद नहीं
कोई माबूद नहीं
और मोहम्मद
मोहम्मद
सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि
वसल्लम
उसके बंदे
और पैगंबर है
माशाल्लाह आप मुसलमान हो चुके अल्लाह आपको जज़ाए खैर दे और अल्लाह आपको हिदायत दे और मैं दुआ करूंगा कि अल्लाह आपको जन्नत नसीब फरमाए. एंड दिस एंड द सेशन एंड आई गिव इट टू माय ब्रदर टू इंशाल्लाह कंटिन्यू विद द नेक्स्ट सेशन.
मेरा एक नाम रख दिया है.